I mean, it is a little bit farcical and a little bit dark. I mean, I used to have a TV show on the BBC called How Not to Live Your Life, which if people had seen that, it's not the same, but there's elements of that, which is I like ordinary people in absurd situations and certainly things that escalate. You know, I've always seen this as a sort of comic tragedy where we're watching through. We're not really rooting for any one person. We're sort of watching this situation unfold. And you kind of can see that they're going to be like, you know that it's going to end badly, but the fun is, how is it going to end? And it's like a little bit edgy and rude and offbeat in places. And I think the messaging in it is hopefully not too hammered over the head with, like, you know, my opinions or anything.
Do you think, given the astonishing lack of trust and confidence we currently have in our political elite, there's something particularly appropriate about this story being told at this time?
Definitely. I think it's very poignant at a time like this, and I hope there's a message in the film that's not shoving it down people's throats, but it is pointing, it is sort of politically pointed. So I just hope that people appreciate the message behind it, really.
We're living at a time where people's confidence and trust in politicians has never been at a lower ebb. Do you think that this is a particularly apropos moment for a story like this?
Yeah, for sure. For sure. I mean, we're living in a cost of living crisis and our politicians don't really seem to care. I say seem, but, like, you know, if you can show me any evidence that they do, I'd be happy to look at it. But it feels like, you know, rent is going up and, you know, landlords don't care. They are putting it up to be in line with inflation, not because anything has changed about their property. And I think that it's such a tough time for people. And I think that that's why this story will really resonate with people, is just because it is such a tough time, and these characters are kind of doing the thing that I think we all cheekily would like to do, but I don't think that it's the best idea. Just to put it out there, it's not the best idea to kidnap politicians.
Definitely not. In terms of your character, he seems so oddly appropriate and symbolic for our current low ebb of confidence in our political elite. Can you tell us a bit more about exactly who he is and where you drew your inspiration for this character?
I mean, it seems odd to say, but almost trying to be as arrogant, as bullish, as Teflon as possible. And it was as if I could do anything. And even then it sort of became almost charming as well, that this character seemed to be winning not only the plot, but the audiences as well. So it does reflect, and we kind of rued the fact that Boris had gone before the film has come out. We were hoping he was going to stay in a bit longer just to give it more relevance. But I don't think there's any problem with that. And it's the fortitude of these people who are so out of touch, but get away with it. And that's what this character does, with somehow some sort of charm, and the audience get behind it, which is kind of scary. So I don't know if there's some common denominator that we can learn from to help us build some confidence back into politics, or some decency, or, you know, honesty or something. I mean, is the honesty now just being a, you know... I think that's why the film works really well, is that you have the sort of my caricature of a politician who's getting away with it and has a certain charm, and then two young people in love and trying to make a life, and he's working two jobs, she's got aspirations, whether it doesn't have to be an actress, but that's it. And it doesn't matter how hard they work or how hard they try, it feels like there needs to be some other action taken to live a life that everybody deserves. And I think it definitely holds a mirror up to what our children are facing and what world they're in. And, you know, what this government have done, privatising the water, like Thames Water, look at that, and their billions of pounds of profit is the exact amount that they are in debt, and that what now we're going to, you know, pay for that. It's we've been hoodwinked. We've been, you know, they've stolen and sold off the country, I'm afraid.